Can I talk to you? Thank you, brother. Turn on. There's a lady that have one leg. It's like a one leg is amputated. I'm talking to you. See, there's this sudden accident that happened in the family, and see that person died of motor accident, an accident that can deform a body, making people become, physical challenge.
Yes, madam.
Yes, he's my husband.
Okay, so please pray, because this is accident before you.
Thank you, man of God.
Because you remember there's one that happened to you.
Yes, man of God.
Yes, it happened.
So I want to send you to the family and the two fruit of the womb. I'm talking to you.
Yes.
Fruit of the womb.
Yes, man of God.
Because the what happened is local sperm. But that is not an issue. God has blessed you. You have a baby girl. Yeah. But this issue of us. Come on. Hey. Help them. What are you standing there for? Help them. Can you carry her there? Because we have much to do. Please. Just let her lie down here, there. How are you, brother? So this is spirit of loss.
Yes.
It's a spirit of loss.
Yes.
And you have been in this pornography.
Yes.
And yet you cannot satisfy yourself.
Yes.
And the thing you cannot, you it has given you so much depression.
Yes.
So I think I need to see, you need a kind of counseling. They have been on the pornography. Yes, that pornography could not solve your problem, but this loss is so much that you don't know what to do.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
So, I want to see.
Moment. Observe su pantalla.
Hey, how are you? Where's your husband? Where's your husband? Because there's so much for this question, and God loves you. You are alone, lonely.
Yes.
All your efforts, you cannot continue to remain lonely.
Yes.
And it is affecting you greatly.
Yes, please.
Come here. Come this way. How are you, brother? Okay, come on. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Come on. So you pray against this cancer, that's a cancerous problem in the family.
Yes, it's true.
Yes, there's a cancer in this family.
It's true.
And it's disturbing the family when a woman died of cancer of breast.
Yes, recently my auntie died of cancer.
Come. So this, your breast is, sometimes it begin to scratch you. There's nothing you have not done. There's a lump growing. But as I'm talking, that will not be your portion again.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
And there's this unity in the family. The family is they scatter.
Yes.
It's okay. I want to see her. And two, there's a court case. So you wait for me. Thank you. How are you?
There's a
lack of affection.
Yes, man of God.
Between you and your wife, the affection is dead.
Yes, at some time we do fight. Sometimes, yes.
That's what I'm saying. They fight all the time. The affection is gone.
Yeah.
So it's your wife. God loves you. Okay? Don't worry. Okay, Sora. What to see? Come on. How are you? They cut your hair. That is when you were sleeping, sometime in the past.
Yes, yes.
Your hair here was cut.
Yes.
But you never bother. I mean, and since that time it caused you separation. After that, you see that the separation came to your life, and you are just don't understand what is going on. And you are now attributed it to family. This is the problem the family are facing.
Yes.
But that should not be family. All the family are divorced. That should not be your case. Everybody can divorce, but you may not divorce. But when we are, we have nothing to say. When we have problems, we start looking at our family. That the same thing in the family.
Yes, sir.
So it's a personal attack on you.
Please,
it's a personal attack for you. There is a property issue. Property. Okay, come on, come to this way.
Il y a 7 ans, dans le passé, ses cheveux ont été coupés, dans son rêve, elle a compris que cela est vrai, qu'elle a compris cela, a fait que son mari l'a quitté. Alors, vous pouvez signer sur la libération.
You have so much trouble in your stomach.
Yes, sir.
What do you think is the cause? Because it has affected even your spinal cord.
Yes, sir.
So you can't sit long.
Yes, sir.
There's a tablet you were taking before. So I want to see her, please. Come on, how are you? Where's your husband? Because I see you marry and remarry. You have to pray against this. Okay? So that is a situation where from one to another, and it's the same thing happened to you. You have great disappointment.
Yes.
Concerning a woman that really demand for your life. It's God that saved you.
It's true.
Huh?
It's true, sir.
So, I mean, you thought when you have this woman, you have the peace you are looking for. But yet, you are still looking for so dear request.
Yes.
Because so dear request that they believe that maybe you are impotent.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
This is true, sir.
You are not an impotent. You can give birth to a child. But it's only it's an attack. So when
it's
you
true.
Sleep in the night, you always see yourself with a woman.
It's true, sir.
Il a dit que cet homme a eu une grande déception auparavant, pensant se marier une deuxième fois, il pensait se trouver son mari conforme, mais il n'en a pas trouvé, qu'il a aussi un problème d'impotence, mais ce n'est pas l'impotence, c'est une attaque.
How about you? What of your mom? Your mom.
Yeah.
I'm asking for your mom. Your mom is trouble?
Yes. Yes, it is true. It is
true. Your mom is trouble.
Yes, it is true.
Don't forget your mom, please.
Hallelujah.
It's just a trouble. Because it's isolated, it's living on our own.
Yes, it is true. Yes, it is true.
Even children, they cannot get close to the mom.
It is true. It is true. It is true, Prophet.
So, please, when are you going to see Mama?
Maybe she will go after. Maybe she will go after this trip. We are from Finland, so.
That is the reason why I should pray for you.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you.
And after the meeting, I want to see you.
Thank you.
If you don't see Mama, Mama may die before you see Mama. Mama is depressed so much.
That is true.
It's worrying.
It's true. It is true. It is true.
And it's a very nice woman.
Yes, it is true.
He stands by her faith. That is the problem he's facing.
It is true. It is true, Prophet.
Yeah. Yes.
Come on.
Preguntaron a su madre que ella está sola y que la tienen que ir a ver porque es una buena mujer.
Cuando yo di a ese couple que esa femme puisse aller voir sa mère, ne pas abandonner sa mère, ils ont dit qu'après ce voyage ici, ils iront voir sa mère effectivement.
How are you? Where is your daughter?
She's in US.
But you received a letter of recent from her.
She sent a message to me.
And there's a message he sent to you.
Yes, please.
There's a problem. It's God will rescue her.
Okay.
From where she's living, she left the place.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
And you count so much on her for your survivor. So I
yes,
want
sir.
To see. I want to see her. Okay. Come on. How are you, Mama? Come on, Mama, for me. Come on.
Oui, Mama. Auparavant, où est ta fille? Il y a un problème et que Dieu va la secourir.
You hear the voice. Sometimes you hear strange voice.
Yes. Yes, huh? Man of God.
Huh?
Yes, man of God.
Come on. There's something in your blood.
Yes.
Blood.
Yes.
I will not call it cancer of blood, which is not cancer, but there is an infection in your blood.
Yes.
That sometimes your blood can cease.
Yes.
So you just wake up in the morning, you cannot see.
Yes.
You become so tired.
Yes.
You have been taking blood tonic.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
So please, I want to see her, please. So you hear strange voice.
Yes, man of God.
What do you think is the cause? What is this? What you hear sometimes, this, that, is a suicide voice.
Yes, man of God.
Huh?
Yes, man of God.
Suicide.
Yes, man of
why,
God.
Why, how this happened? How come about this?
It just happened when I passed through hard times.
Oh. Okay, come this way. How are you, brother? So there is a spirit of death.
Yes, man
your
of God.
Your dear one died, loved one. I want to see her. That should not take you aback. You should put it behind. Okay, and move forward. I want to see her, please. How are you? So, I mean, you see yourself preaching and teaching in the dream all the time. You preach.
It's true, man.
But if you have seen something in the dream, that does not mean it. You need to know what it means. So when and how? Okay.
Okay, man. Of God. Thank you.
You started it physically. This is an attack.
It's true, man. Of God.
It's an attack. So go and started this physically. It's an attack on you.
Quand Dieu a dit qu'il ne va pas se voir dans le rêve à prêcher et prier pour les gens qui doivent commencer physiquement, il l'a fait physiquement et il a reçu des attaques.
There is somebody in the mortuary. Somebody, there is a dead body.
Yes.
How are you? How are you, brother? Come on. What's your problem with the land, the issue of land?
I'm looking for a way to enter where I build my house, an entrance.
Because I see they block your way.
Yeah, they block my way.
And that portion belongs to you, and they block it, and there is no way you could enter it.
That's the problem. I went to solve the problem last 2 weeks. I could not solve the problem. I went to meet the woman that the owner of the land. The woman refused to give me an entrance.
He refused to open the place.
Yes, sir.
You have to be very, very careful.
Okay, sir.
Very, very, very careful.
Okay, sir.
I think that alone is a trap because you have offended them so much, and they are looking for a way of catching you.
Okay, sir.
And God loves you.
Okay,
and
sir.
Remember, you just have a disagreement, a separation of reason. Okay, so I want to see him. God loves you so much. Okay, where is your vehicle?
I have many. Is it
the Jeep?
Okay, is it on, sir?
This Jeep keep having tire burst.
It has tire burst when we are traveling home with it with my wife. When they were traveling home with it last time, it has tire burst in Kaduna.
Please stop using it. Okay, change the tires, the one that have tire bar, change the tire,
okay, sir,
and then dispose it.
Okay, sir.
Okay, it's a blessing to whoever, but not blessing to you.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I want to see him.
Okay.
Come on, take him on. What happened to this lady? Why did she walk out of your house?
We had a fight, man of God.
Eh?
We had a fight, man of God.
You have fight?
Yes.
Over what?
Infidelity.
Can you see what I'm talking about today? Yeah? Our regular relationship can break out of sheer circumstances, not out of God's release. It's God that gave you a child. Eh? So near that, without allow God to release them, he say it's not given, it's not conceived. He say it should go. I say, these are challenges we have. These are the problem we have. Because what I was saying here is that this is the second disappointment you have now.
Yes, man of God.
Second.
Yes, man of God.
So the former one to the same thing. Is as a result of the way you quit the relationship. The way you quit the relationship is the way you enter the new relationship.
That's true.
Tell your neighbor. If you, because of disagreement, quit relationship, the relationship you will enter next, it will be battered with disagreement. If you, because of he's talking of barrenness, because of that he quit the marriage, that barrenness spirit will continue to follow him. Another marriage will be full of barrenness. Check your, please, can you take, sit down and think about your life. You, what I'm saying, you say, is a purely true of one's life. The way you leave one relationship is the same way you enter the next relationship. Tell your neighbor. I can't hear you. Even the person you meet also is in trouble for meeting you, because like I have said, it is impossible to establish a healthy relationship with a person who has left another relationship bitter and offended. I want to see you, brother, because if you are not rescued now, I don't know, you continue. It's many of us here that have so much experiences of what I'm talking about. Even your business, there's, you have once a contractor, builder, you left builder building a lot. You do different things, different businesses. Because the way we go about our life, simple. I show you my documentary where I started the first church, second church, third church, fourth church, This is sixth church. The first one was destroyed by a storm. The second one was destroyed by rain. The third one too was destroyed. The fourth one, but I never give up, because I will never quit, because it's a relationship involved by God. Your heart.
Yes, sir.
There's a tablet you are using.
Yes, sir.
Because sometimes your heart can cease. Even when you are sleeping, it's always fear.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's not only you. The same thing happened to your father.
Yes, sir.
It's an inheritance. It's an accessory.
It's true, sir.
How are you, brother? So, update the issue of money.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
How do you go about it? This is the second time now. Even
I was accused of owing somebody, which
that is not some say because
I was not owing him.
Somebody accused you of money.
Yes, sir.
And this is the third time now.
Yeah, they even took me to IDO and summoned me and charged me to pay about 20
that
million.
That was the second time they took you to the IDO.
Yes, sir.
To go and swear.
Yeah.
What later happened?
I later called the police for them.
You called police for them?
Yeah, because I want to owe anything, man.
But the problem you have now, you have gone too far before you call police. And the case is still hanging.
Yeah, the case is hanging the police. So I came to know what God will say about it.
To me, that's the reason why you are here.
Yes, sir.
Don't worry. So you come back to give testimony. But not that you don't. Look, the money they measure is not exactly.
Yes, sir.
That is why you disagree. Not that there's no money issue, but there's issue of money between you and them.
Yeah.
But they exaggerate the whole thing.
The issue of money, the money got lost. Mine is two times more than his that got lost.
That's what I'm saying. So go and wait for me, I'll see you.
Observe the time of prophecy.
What of your husband? Because I see you going in and coming out. Going in and coming out.
Yeah.
Going in and coming out. You know, as a young woman, this is till the time.
Yes, man of
till
God.
Till the time you go into the house for relationship and come out again.
Yes, man
go
of
in
God.
Again and come out again. So, what is the problem?
I was not sure of what I was doing. That's why I was looking for God's opinion.
You were not sure?
Yes, man of God.
What you are doing? You say you are not sure.
Yes, man of God.
What are you not sure of?
If he is a true husband from God, if he is meant for me.
If it is what?
If he is meant for me.
Who?
He's called Baraka.
The husband?
I'm not yet married, man of God.
The person meant for you?
Yes.
But you have gone too far with one man, so I think I need to see you. There's a short man.
Okay.
There's one that is very short and fat.
Okay.
Eh?
Yes, man of God.
You know him?
He is in China.
He's in China?
Yes.
He was in Hong Kong before.
Hong Kong, yes, well, man of God.
Okay, so go away from me. Go.
De la prophétie de cette femme, le mujahidin, pourquoi est-ce que ça fait la deuxième
he
fois?
He has husband, doesn't know where the husband lives.
It's
in China, it's all gone. Okay, brother, come on. Where is your son?
My daughter.
Your daughter.
It's in Tanzania. She's
but there is one song I want to see you for, okay?
Yeah.
There's a controversy.
It's true, man of God. It's true. It's very true.
No worry, I will not say more than that. I want to see you privately. Because I don't want anything to affect your death. I don't want to settle another matter. Okay, go and wait for me.
Are you
I say, sorry, he said daughter. I don't know. I say no, this one is a controversy one. He says it's true, it's true, it's true. Okay, let's cover it. Okay, about you. Okay, so since I'm going to see you after the service at the where? Somewhere. I don't want to mention the place. So after my brother here, please, we leave everything to after service, okay? Brother, why you? They invite you home. This is December. You have to go.
Yes, ma'am.
Because there's a reconciliation going on in the family.
Yes, ma'am. God.
Okay. They are not saying you should come and serve idol because your family serve idol.
Yes, ma'am. God.
Your father is a chief king.
Yes.
When he was there for them.
Yes, man of God.
So they are not saying, but you just go home and help them.
Yes, man.
Okay.
Of God. Yes.
So because your brother, one of your brother was late.
Yes, man of God.
So you are the one they are looking onto. So you can't abandon that house, okay?
Yes, man.
I want to see you. You wait to see, and see me. Okay, this is your spectacle. Brother, how are you?
I'm fine, sir.
Mm-hmm. So you have a calling. You have a calling, but it's not yet ripe.
You should begin
to nurture that calling.
Thank you.
Calling is when a calling start, it's like a baby.
Yes, sir.
We have to nurture it and grow and grow and grow. Get your home ready.
Thank you.
Your family ready.
Yes,
your
sir.
Friend ready.
Okay,
those friends you don't need to go on with. Put your home in order.
Thank you, sir.
So that when it comes, it will not become a blasphemy.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
So I want to see you. Where is your father?
My father is dead.
He's dead.
Yes, sir.
Do you know the reason why I'm asking? He's a head of the community.
It's true. Thank you. It's true.
He's a head of the community.
Yes,
and
sir.
They want you to take after him.
It's true. It's true.
So,
that's what my earlier brothers, my elderly ones, they normally tell me.
And this fruit of the womb.
Thank you.
It's true. It's true.
But you keep praying with a baby girl.
Yes, man of God.
So that is what God wants to give you.
Amen.
So I want to see you, huh?
L'appel est juste en train d'être.
If I don't answer you now, you think maybe you look more down. I will answer you. Because you are the only person on the road. Have you taken your decision?
Yes.
Do you know the decision I'm talking about?
Mm-mm.
This is the second time now. You have to take that decision now. Okay?
Okay.
You must know where you are going at this point.
Okay.
You must know where you are going at this point.
Okay.
Where you are living is not where you are supposed to live.
Okay.
You know that. Okay?
Okay.
And you own debts.
Yes.
You own a man debts.
Okay.
Not okay.
Yes. Thank you.
Go on. Hey, carry her there. Carry her. Who are you? Come on.
Who are you in this body?
Don't worry, I'll see people after the service. We are ready for that, okay? Don't worry, okay? Take her. Okay, thank you.
Yes!
Oh, babe!
What have you done? Speak out, what have you done? How do you destroy that? Who are you in this body? Who are you?
I'm you. Thank God!
Okay, how have you destroyed the family? The family!
I've taken their stuff! Yes.
What else? What else have you done? A career. What have you done to a career?
I don't want her to proceed.
Uh-huh.
She'll be very rich.
Oh, yeah? How did you enter this body? How did you enter her? How did you enter her?
No.
How did you enter her?
I feel shame.
Speak out. How did you enter her?
I killed her mother.
Entendre la confession de l'esprit méchant disant qu'il a pris son étoile, qu'il veut la détruire.
I want to kill her. I killed her mother. Yes. They are shining like stars. I'm his grandfather.
L'esprit dit qu'il veut la tuer.
Estamos en el tiempo de profecía y liberación con el profeta TV Joshua.
It's a session of prophecy by the anointed man of God in the midst of the congregation, and a whole lot of people received divine message of prophecy about their lives, and because of time we could not listen to them instantly, and now we want to listen to them one after the other as they confirm the prophecy of the anointed man of God, Senior Prophet TB Joshua. So we welcome you to the Synagogue Church of All Nations. In Jesus' name, can you please tell us your name and where you come from?
I am Abdullahi Fatal. I'm from Ghana. This is my third time of coming to the Synagogue Church of All Nations.
And can you share with us the message of prophecy you received from the man of God a while ago?
Emmanuel, children of God. Man of God professes to me that I have a heart problem and that I am on a tablet. And he also prophesies that it's an inheritance problem, that my father is also on the same tablet that I am. It means that my father has the same problem that I have. I can confirm that the prophecy is true because my heart seizes sometimes when I'm sleeping, and I have to always take tablet when I'm about to sleep. So I confirm that the prophecy is true, and I thank Jesus for saving me.
Shall we clap for Jesus Christ? Glory be to God in the highest. You can hear the man confirming that everything the man of God told him in the message of prophecy, that he has been using a tablet because of a heart problem he has, and the heart used to cease, and that this is an inheritance, that the father equally had the same problem, and he confirmed everything to be true. And you believe that this prophecy has brought an end to the common calamity of life you have been facing?
Yes, yes.
So we thank God Almighty for your life, and we pray that the Spirit of the Lord who has revealed this problem has put an end to your problem, and your past is indeed over in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Escuchamos la confirmación de esta profecía del hombre que dice que sí está enfermo del corazón, que estaba enfermo del corazón y era un problema hereditario, pero recibió hoy liberación por parte del profeta TV Joshua.
Cet homme est en train de confirmer la prophétie que l'homme de Dieu lui a donnée, disant qu'il a un problème de cœur. Effectivement, son père aussi avait ce même problème de cœur. C'est ce problème de cœur qui justement a tué son père. Et confirme que la prophétie est vraie, qu'il a ce problème effectivement.
Your name and where you're from.
My name is Josephine and I'm from Tanzania. A while ago, we saw that you received the word of prophecy from Prophet TB Joshua. Can you tell us the exact words of prophecy you received?
The man of God told me that there is cancer in the family, and I confirmed that to be true. Recently, my aunt died of cancer, internal organs, and also when I was coming here, my father told me to pray for him for prostate. And on my mother's side, most of his siblings died of cancer in one way or another. Even recently, my mother had a problem of ulcer, and they were suspecting that like maybe she should do cancer checkup based on our background, that most of our siblings died of cancer. And also Prophet told me that in my left breast, like there is a sign of cancer. That is true. He told me there is itching. The itching comes in my breast and goes at times. So he told me that I'm delivered from the spirit of cancer. And I thank you, Jesus, for that. He also told me about this unit. I could say yes. And I believe that God has settled all the case of me and my family. Thank you, Jesus.
We thank God Almighty for this word of prophecy you've received, and we know that this prophecy has brought deliverance to the entire family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Escuchamos otra confirmación de profecía. El hombre de Dios le dijo que en su familia había cáncer y ella lo confirma diciendo que en sus tías, muchas de ellas han muerto de cáncer, y además el hombre de Dios le habló acerca de cáncer de seno y ella confirma porque ha tenido una extraña sensación en uno de sus senos. Así que da la gloria a Dios por esta palabra de profecía.
Oui, l'homme de Dieu lui a donné une prophétie disant qu'il y avait un problème de cancer dans la famille. Effectivement, il confirme que cela est vrai, que sa tante est morte du cancer il n'y a pas très longtemps, que même la plupart des frères et sœurs de sa mère sont aussi morts du cancer. Et l'homme de Dieu lui a aussi dit qu'elle a l'habitude de se gratter le sein. Elle a confirmé que cela est vrai. L'homme de Dieu a dit que c'était le signe justement d'un cancer qui approchait. Et elle rend toute la gloire à Dieu que cette prophétie est sortie, qu'elle est libre maintenant de tout cancer, de cette malédiction familiale.
Prophecy from people whom God Almighty spoke through His anointed servant, Prophet TB Joshua. And we have another couple right here that want to confirm the prophetic message they received during today's service. So you're very much welcome. Can you introduce yourself and the person standing beside you and the prophecy that you received from Prophet TB Joshua?
My name is Arnold Ngarashi. I'm from Tanzania. Beside me is my darling wife called Gwaliwa Donini Miranda. We both come from Tanzania. What man of God prophesies about lack of affection in our marriage is true. Because I remember at the beginning of our marriage, I was having a spirit of anger, so we used to fight a lot, to an extent that we were called by, you know, parents trying to find a solution to the problem. After that we started to improve and I started to control myself. We went for prayers as well, starting to engage God into our marriage, and the situation improved.
Okay, can you tell us how the spirit of anger and lack of affection affects your marriage, even to the extent of productivity and fruitfulness in the marriage?
There are times when, you know, husband and wife, you're supposed to meet, you know, and you're not, because, you know, you fight for just little small things, because I used to like perfection, so that has brought a lot of issues, because to my background I always like 1 + 1 = 2, so that has always been a challenge to me. But thank God right now I'm fine, I'm okay, I'm set free by Jesus name.
So you mean that this spirit of anger affected the marriage to the extent that even you are not able to meet sometimes as husband and wife due to the terrible anger and lack of affection in the marriage?
That's very true.
So how many children do you have in the marriage right now?
What? I don't have any children so far. Yes.
So you are confirming all what the man of God said to be true?
Yes, it's true.
Okay, so right now let us hear from your wife what she has to say in confirmation of the words of prophecy. So, madam, you are very much welcome. You have heard the words of prophecy given to you and your husband. So what do you want to say in confirmation of that words of prophecy?
Emmanuel, my name is Mrs. Gwaliwa Dorini Miranda, and I confess the prophecy to be true. We have been quarreling and fighting always, and that has been a reason for loss and affection in our marriage. But I'm thanking God today we have been delivered. Glory be to God. We are thanking God.
Hallelujah. We give glory to God Almighty, as you said, that with these words of prophecy you have received today, you know, it has brought about freedom and breakthrough in your marriage. And we give glory to God for that. I want to advise you that now that God Almighty has spoken words of freedom into your life, set you free from all the problems, spirit of anger in this marriage. We want you to make sure you follow him along the way and making this word a standard for your life. And we'll continue to guide your steps in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Esta pareja confirma que lo que el hombre de Dios le dijo es 100% cierto. El hombre de Dios profetizó falta de amor en el matrimonio, muchas peleas y espíritu de enojo en la mujer. Y ellos confirman que es así porque venían presentando muchos problemas en su matrimonio. Confirman que es 100% verdadero lo que el profeta les dijo.
L'homme de Dieu a prophétisé qu'il y avait un manque d'affection. Effectivement, sa femme avait l'esprit de colère qui a causé le manque d'affection dans le mariage et qui fait qu'il ne pouvait pas avoir d'enfant s'il n'y avait pas d'affection. Mais je lui rends la gloire à Dieu que sa femme a été délivrée. Cette parole prophétique qui a amené la délivrance dans ce couple.
Received messages of prophecy a moment ago from the man of God, Senior Prophet TB Joshua. Welcome you in Jesus' name. Could you introduce yourself to us and tell us where you come from?
Emmanuel.
My name is Kojo Boso, and then next to me is my wife, Mawena Boso. We are from Ghana.
A moment ago, you had a message of prophecy from the man of God, Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua. Could you tell us exactly the words of prophecy you received and how you can confirm this to be true for your lives?
Thank you. Yeah, during the prophecy time today, man of God, Prophet T.B. Joshua, walked to me. And he went straight and direct to my heart. He gave me 3 strong prophecies. The first one was that I have a call of God on me, which means I'm supposed to be a worker for God. But he said, it's not yet time, or it's not yet mature, and I need to work towards activating that call in my life, which I confirm to be true. Now, the second prophecy was that he asked me if where is my father, and I told him my father is no more. And he asked me if I know why he asked me of where was my father, and I said no. And he went on to say, because my father was the head of our community, and I am supposed to take over, or they want me to take over from him, which I also confirmed to be true. Now, there are a few signals to this prophecy. 2 issues. Now, anytime I get back to my community, the elderly ones, that is those in my father's class, anytime they meet me, it looks like they're very happy to see me, but I don't know why. But normally I thought that because I look like him, that is why they normally develop that sort of happiness or joy seeing me. And they normally go on giving me a lot of good things on who was my father to them. I didn't grow to know him very well before he died, but through his friends, I got a lot of information from my father. So that really confirmed the prophecy, number 2. And also my brothers, the older ones, they normally come to me for assistance. And I don't complain. I give to them. And they turn around to tell me, do I know why they normally come to me for help? And I normally tell them, no, I don't know. And they tell me that when our father was about to go to die, he spoke to them that I, the younger one, should take care of the elderly ones for him. So it's also confirmed that prophecy number 2. Now, the third one, or the last one, but not the least, that he said, there is an issue of the fruit of the womb, which is so straight. In fact, it is 100%. Now, we and my wife, we have been together as husband and wife for, more than 12 years now, and our prayer daily is for the fruits of the womb. So that is also perfectly correct. Now, he went on to tell my wife that she has been breastfeeding or expecting a baby girl. And I believe that is our portion. Amen.
To God be the glory. And how do you feel right now? I haven't heard these messages or prophecies from the man of God. How do you feel?
I think I'm the happiest person right now, because there's no doubt about it. It's true.
Thank you very much. Let's briefly hear from your wife. Madam, welcome you in Jesus' name. Could you tell us your name and who is the man next to you?
Emmanuel. My name is Mrs. Mariana Bosu. This is my lovely husband. We are from Ghana.
Okay. How do you feel? Haven't heard this message of prophecy from the man of God, Prophet T.B. Joshua.
Everything that the prophet told us is true, 100% true. And very soon, we will bring our baby girl to the church.
Amen. And we really rejoice with you. I haven't had this message of prophecy from the man of God, Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua. We also wait expectantly alongside with you that very soon you'll be coming with your baby to share your testimony in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Go and make the word of God a standard for your life.
Nous allons entendre la confirmation de la prophétie de ce couple. L'homme de Dieu a dit à cet homme en premier qu'il voit qu'il a un appel de Dieu. Et effectivement, l'homme de Dieu lui a dit que cet appel n'est pas encore arrivé à maturité, qu'il doit patienter, afin d'être mature dans cet appel, afin de rentrer dans cet appel. Une deuxième chose, l'homme de Dieu lui a dit: où est ton père? Parce qu'il voit que son père était à la tête d'une communauté. Il a confirmé que cela est vrai, que son père est mort, mais qu'il était à la tête justement de sa communauté. Et l'homme de Dieu lui a dit qu'il veut que justement il prenne la place de son père. Il a confirmé que cela est vrai. Il a dit que même à sa mort, son père aussi a dit à ses frères qui ont l'habitude de le voir quand ils ont besoin de quelque chose, que s'ils avaient besoin de quoi que ce soit, que même les plus grands frères devaient justement le rencontrer le plus jeune, s'il avait besoin d'aide, pour confirmer que son père lui-même avait déjà déclaré qu'il serait la tête de la communauté, car ses frères qui sont plus âgés que lui viennent souvent le voir pour avoir de l'aide venant de lui. Il a dit aussi une troisième chose, l'homme de Dieu a dit qu'il cherche le fruit des entrailles. Effectivement, ils ont ce problème de stérilité, et l'homme de Dieu aussi a confirmé qu'il a l'habitude de voir sa femme a l'habitude de voir dans son rêve une petite fille justement qu'elle allait, et a fait confirmer que cela est vrai. L'homme de Dieu a dit que c'est effectivement une petite fille que Dieu veut leur donner.
Escuchamos esta confirmación de profecía. El hombre de Dios le habló al esposo diciendo que tenía un llamado, que aún no estaba preparado y listo para empezarlo a ejercer, pero que tenía un llamado de parte de Dios. Y además, junto a su esposa, les profetizó acerca del fruto del vientre y que estaban buscando el nacimiento de una bebé. Ellos confirman esta profecía diciendo que han estado por mucho tiempo buscando una hija y que no habían podido, pero hoy, para la gloria de Dios, han recibido liberación y el progreso que esperaban. Continuamos con confirmaciones de profecías.
From those who received messages of prophecy from Prophet T.B. Joshua in today's devotional service, be blessed as you listen to this couple as they come out to share their experience. Sir, tell us your name, where you come from.
I am Derry Clement. I'm from Cameroon.
And who is the woman that is standing next to you?
The woman beside me is my lovely wife.
Can you tell us the messages of prophecy you received from Prophet T.B. Joshua today?
Please, I need your clemency because my English is not the best. I am here to confirm the prophecy of man of God, Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua. He tells me that he has seen Mary and remarried, and I must pray against it. Secondly, he talked about disappointment, and finally about impotency. Concerning Mary and remarry, I can say that I'm married with my wife 10 years ago. And after 6 years, there's no child. My family, my friends begin to say that I'm impotent, I cannot have a child, I cannot make a child. That situation determines me to go out to prove that if it is true or false. So I went out, I met a young girl, and I asked her to accept to make a child with me. She accepted. And after 4 months, she got pregnant. And she gave birth to a baby girl. That baby has 3 years today.
You mean the baby is just 3 years old?
Yes. And after that, that girl wants me to marry her. And I tell her that our contract is finished. I am married.
Sorry, sir, for the benefit of viewers that are listening to you, what was the contract? What was the initial agreement?
The contract was that she accept to give me a baby and stop the relationship. Because I wanted to show that I am not important man. But the girls in her mind wants me to be her husband. And she wanted that to separate me with my wife. That's about the marry and remarriage that the man of God talk about.
After she gave birth to the child and refused to leave you alone in regard to the initial contract of just having a baby with you and leaving you and your marriage, has she given the baby to you?
No, she refuses to give me the baby. Today the baby is still with her.
Viewers all over the world, you have listened to the man in question. Remember the prophetic message given to this couple, particularly to the man himself. The man of God said that he's seen marry and remarry, and that he's seen disappointment concerning a woman who is demanding for his life, that it's only God has saved him from it. And also that people are saying that he's an impotent man. That is not impotency per se, but an attack. And the man is here confirming the messages of prophecy, or Prophet TV Joshua, to be true, that this almost led to issue of marry and remarry. We want to hear from Madam. Madam, can we hear from you? What can you say about the message of prophecy that your husband received in today's service?
All what the man of God, Prophet TV Joshua.
Introduce yourself. Introduce yourself. Your name.
My name is Dairy Christine. I came from Cameroon.
And who is the man standing next to you?
This is my husband.
What can you say about the message of prophecy he received?
All what the man of God said is true. Marry and remarry, the issue of this woman and his impotency is true.
So you are confirming that everything the man of God prophesied to him today is nothing but the truth?
Yes, it's true. 10 years without a baby.
To God be the glory. Sir, we just want to hear from you once again. What do you believe that this message of prophecy that came through Prophet TB Joshua has done in your life and in your marriage?
Yes, about marry and remarry, I think that that woman who wants me to marry her is that problem about against which we have to pray, as the man of God said to me.
What do you have to say about the message of prophecy?
I can say that all the words of man of God are true. Because concerning the second prophecy, concerning the impotency, all my family and me too, before thinks that I am impotent.
But now, by the grace of God, you believe you are not, going by the message of prophecy of the man of God. Is that correct? You believe you are not an impotent man?
Yes, I believe I am not an impotent man.
We thank God for your life, for this message of prophecy, and we believe through these words of prophecy given by Prophet T.B. Joshua, the end has come to the common calamities in your life and in this marriage, as you go and make the word of God a standard for your life, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Esta pareja confirma la profecía dada por el profeta T.B. Joshua, donde él les dijo que veía que se casaba una y otra vez. Ellos confirman que es verdad, debido a que en su matrimonio estaban teniendo muchos problemas, porque no había sido posible para ellos tener hijos. Así que debido a un problema de impotencia que este hombre tenía en su cuerpo. Así que debido a eso, él salió de su casa buscando respuesta. Conoció a otra mujer, quien le insistía que se casara con ella y que dejara a su mujer. Entonces ellos confirman que esta palabra de profecía es realmente verdadera y da gracias a Dios por esto.
D'entendre la confirmation de prophétie de ce couple, où l'homme de Dieu a dit qu'il voit deux déceptions, la famille que cela est vrai, mariage et remariage. Dieu aussi avait été accusé d'impotence, mais qu'il n'est pas impotent. Effectivement, il a confirmé que cela est vrai, quand même, de sa première relation. Il a eu un enfant avec cette première relation, effectivement, confirmant qu'il n'est pas impotent. Il rend toute la gloire à Dieu pour cette parole prophétique.